Hi, I'm Matt Hall, and today I'm going to go over basic operations and pre-trip inspection of the all-new Bell 45E articulated dump truck. Before you start your day and climb onto the machine, you're going to want to check out the maintenance chart. On the maintenance chart, you're going to find things that need to be checked daily, such as grease points, air pressure in your tires, fluid levels. Something that's very important, but it's often overlooked, is the inflation of a tire. Underinflation and overinflation can cause multiple problems. Top off your diesel fuel here. Most importantly, the DEF fluid. This blue cap, every day, regardless whether it's 90% full, 25% full, these trucks do not regen, so it's important, this fluid, to stay in the machine full at all times. It's very important that you give a basic visual inspection, including oil leaks and grease lines. Another defining feature of the Bell E-Series trucks is the three-point mounted suspension. It allows each wheel to move independently of each other. The cabs sit floor level. You don't have to scoop the dirt out, you don't have to vacuum the dirt out, and it makes it easy when you're stepping in, there's nothing to trip on. One thing that you're going to notice when you climb into the cab of these trucks, you don't need a key. They run off of a push button that requires a four-digit code. To get things started and bring up the display monitor, first you're going to push this green button. The default codes for these trucks are found on the serial tag, and it's the last four digits of the PIN number. The beauty of it is, each individual driver can be given their own code, where the foremen of the job site can track their production, load counts, their fuel consumption, and individual style of driving of these trucks. Everyone knows how hard it is to adjust your mirrors to get them just right. You climb out of the cab, you climb in the cab. You climb out of the cab, you climb in the cab. Then you break a mirror. Not with these trucks. You've got it right here at your fingertips. Another feature of Bell, electric and heated mirrors. You might find something different but yet familiar about the accelerator and brake pedal. They're suspended like an automobile instead of mounted on the floor like our competitors. We've got the throttle pedal, brake pedal, high and low beams, turn signals, but more importantly, we have the keypad right here. This is where all the functions of the truck are controlled. This area of buttons controls all of the end cap functions. This button, when you hit it one time, turns on your parking lights. You hit it twice, turns on your headlights. The bottom left-hand button is the mirror defroster. The other light button on this panel controls your work lights. This is your front windshield wiper button, and it has four speed settings. The red button with the P is your parking brake. Once you've started the machine, the parking brake will be on. You'll turn the parking brake off by hitting the red button with the P on it. In normal operation throughout the day, you'll no longer need to hit that button. Throw it into neutral, it holds the truck still until you're ready to take off. Throw it back in gear, accelerate, and move on. This is the gear hold button. When you press this button, it keeps the truck in the gear that you have selected and it won't allow it to shift. This button is a unique feature to Bell. It's called the I-tip. The first light is called the hard stops. It doesn't feather when it comes back, stops hard, shakes things loose from your bed. The second light activates driveline assist, and that's where the machine automatically dumps your load for you. A third press of the button activates the load spreading. Now, the load spreading can be set up different ways depending on how fast you want to go and the rate of the bed coming up. The up and down arrows on this button adjust your retarder from 25% to full. Sometimes there's some confusion. If you hold that button down and the lights begin to flash, from that point, you're actually adjusting the speed of the truck. You're also going to see a blue arrow on the speedometer indicating the top speed that the machine can go at that time. To disable this feature once the lights are flashing, just hold the button down. It will go back to one button and you can begin to reset your retarder. On the Bell E-Series trucks, you can actually raise the hood by just a push of the button. The days of popping the hood and pulling a dipstick to check your fluids, it's gone. Right here on the B drive, you hit the E button, pulls up the main monitor. From this screen, you'll be able to check the levels on your engine oil, transmission, auto greaser, and other daily checks. When shutting down a machine, you're going to hit the red stop button. Don't be alarmed that the machine doesn't shut down right away. It takes time. The turbo will cool down and the DEF lines will clean out. Could be up to 4 minutes. Please make sure that you don't turn off the master switch before you hear the backup alarm beep 3 times. Another awesome perk about Bell Trucks is Fleetmatics. All of your trucks in your fleet can be monitored off-site from any computer. We designed this video to help operators get more acquainted with these trucks. If you have any questions, you can always refer to the operator's manual about all the functionalities that are offered in the Bell E-Series.